Good morning, boys and girls. I'm so happy to see all of you today. Today, the story that I'm going to read you is called The Tiny Seed. And when you look at the cover of this book, do you have a guess who the author is and the illustrator? This person wrote the words and made the pictures. Do you know? It's Eric Carle. Did you notice the collage and the flower in the background of the page of the picture? It's really beautiful. Before we read the story, let's get our bodies ready, okay? Hands up and we'll sing, open, shut them, give a little clap, clap, clap. Open, shut them, place them on your lap, lap, lap. Nice job, everybody is looking ready. The Tiny Seed by Eric Carle. Here's the title page. And now the story is beginning. It is autumn. A strong wind is blowing. It blows flower seeds high in the air and carries them far across the land. One of the seeds is tiny. It's smaller than any of the others. Will it be able to keep up with the others? And where are they going? Do you see the tiny seed right here? It's very small. I wonder if it will be able to keep up and what will happen to it. One of the seeds flies higher than the others. Up, up it goes. It flies too high and the sun's hot rays burn it up. But the tiny seed sails on with the others. So here's the tiny seed right here. This seed got too close to the sun and it burned. All these seeds are still down here. Another seed lands on a tall and icy mountain. Do you see it right here? The ice never melts and the seed cannot grow. The rest of the seeds fly on by, but the tiny seed does not go as fast as the others. Now they fly over the ocean. One seed falls into the water and drowns. The others sail on with the wind, but the tiny seed does not go as high as the others. So there's the tiny seed right there. Here's the other seeds. They're up higher. The tiny seed does not go as high as them. One seed drifts down into the desert. It is hot and dry, and the seed cannot grow. Now the tiny seed is flying very low, but the wind pushes it on with the others. Why can't the seed grow in the desert? Do you know? Seeds need sun and water to grow into plants. In this seed, it must not be a cactus. Cactus grow in the desert. This seed, it will not grow. Finally, the wind stops and the seeds fall gently down on the ground. A bird comes by and it eats one seed. The tiny seed is not eaten. It is so small that the bird does not see it. It's right here. Look how tiny it is. Those other seeds are kind of big. The tiny seed's right there. Now, it is winter. After their long trip, the seeds settle down. They look just as if they are going to sleep in the earth. Snow falls and covers them like a soft white blanket. A hungry mouse that also lives in the ground eats a seed for his lunch. But the tiny seed lies very still and the mouse does not see it. I think that one's the tiny seed. Oh, it's laying very still. The mouse is eating this seed right here. Now it is spring. spring. It's spring for us right now, too. After a few months, the snow has melted, and it is really spring. Birds fly by, the sun shines, rain falls. The seeds grow so round and full that they start to burst open a little. Now, they are not seeds anymore. They are plants. First they send roots, here's the roots, down into the earth. Then their little stems and leaves begin to grow up toward the sun. So here's their stems, and then there's the leaves. The stems are the long part, and here are the leaves. There is another plant that grows much faster than the new little plants. It is a big, fat weed, and it takes all the sunlight and the rain away from one of the small new plants, and that plant does not grow anymore. The tiny seed hasn't begun to grow yet. It will be too late. Hurry! But finally, it too starts to grow into a plant. So there it is. It's starting to grow into a plant. The warm weather also brings the children out to play. They too have been waiting for the sun in springtime. One child doesn't see the plant as he runs along and, oh no, he breaks one. Now it cannot grow anymore. The tiny plant that grew from a tiny seed is growing fast, but its neighbor grows even faster. Before the tiny plant has three leaves, the other plant has seven. Oh, let's count these leaves. Will you guys help me? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. It does have seven leaves. That's a lot of leaves on a flower. And look, a bud. And now even a flower. But what is happening? First, there are footsteps. Then a shadow looms over them. Then a hand reaches down and breaks off the flower. So what happened? I think someone picked the flower. A boy has picked a flower to give to his friend. Oh, he picked the flower and gave it to his friend. That was thoughtful. It is summer. Now the tiny plant from the tiny seed is all alone. It grows on and on. It doesn't stop. The sun shines on it and the rain waters it. It has many leaves. It grows taller and taller. It is taller than the people. It is taller than the trees. It is taller than the houses. And now a flower grows on it. People come from far and near to look at this flower. It is the tallest flower they have ever seen. It is a giant flower. Oh my goodness! Wouldn't it be amazing to see a flower that was taller than a house? Wow! I think I would want to see one of those. All summer long, the birds and bees and butterflies come visiting. They have never seen such a big and beautiful flower. Now, it is autumn again. The days grow shorter, the nights grow cooler, and the wind carries yellow and red leaves past the flower. Some petals drop from the giant flower. These are the petals right here. Those are all the petals. They drop from the giant flower and they sail along with the bright leaves over the land and down to the ground. The wind blows harder. The flower has lost almost all of its petals. It sways and bends from the wind, but the wind grows stronger and shakes the flower. Once more, the wind shakes the flower, and this time, the flower's seed pod, right in the middle of the flower, that's where the seed pod is, out come many tiny seeds that quickly sail far away in the wind. So the wind blew hard, and it blew the petals off the flower, and then the seed pod, right in the middle, it blew the seeds into the air. What do you think is going to happen to all of those seeds? It might happen. It might. I bet it all starts over again. I bet those seeds travel far and wide, and maybe some of them will find a safe spot to land and grow. Yeah. I really hope that you liked our story today, friends. The tiny seed. But right now, it's time to say goodbye. Can you all get your goodbye hands ready? All right, we'll sing. Goodbye, friends. Goodbye, friends. Goodbye, friends. It's time to say goodbye. Bye, boys and girls. I'll see you all soon.